A young boy is in a critical condition after an accident at a school on the northern beaches. Kelly Fedora is at Sydney Children's Hospital. Kelly, what happened?
Well, Mark, we understand that the Year 3 student was running in an area at the Mona Vale School this morning when he tripped and fell. He hit his head and he went into cardiac arrest. Other students watched from their classrooms as a boy was loaded onto a care flight helicopter and brought here to the Sydney Children's Hospital in Randwick in a critical condition. Another couple believed to be his parents were at the scene. They arrived here a short time later, no doubt, by his bedside as doctors here treat his injuries. The other parents at the school were notified and told not to call, that the relevant parents had already been told. Now, obviously, the Department of Education will investigate this. There are reports that he tripped on a tree root in that area. It was away from playground equipment. It is possible, Mark, that this was just a freak accident.
Okay, Kelly, thank you. An elderly resident of the New March House nursing home near Penrith has died. The resident had previously tested positive for coronavirus but returned two negative tests before passing away. Officially, 16 people have now died from COVID-19, with two more people dying shortly after recovering from the virus. Well, health authorities have identified a handful of suburbs in Sydney's southwest as hotspots for virus outbreaks. Residents in the Canada Bay, Canterbury, Bankstown and Cumberland council areas are urged to come forward for testing amid a warning as restrictions are set to ease.
Not only do we have the virus to deal with as our enemy, but also complacency. We cannot afford to be complacent. We have to assume every time we leave the house that we have the virus and everybody else we come into contact with has the virus. That's how we need to live our lives until the pandemic is over. And the pandemic won't be over until we either have a cure or a vaccine, and that could be some time away. So please do not be complacent. Even when you're out in a gathering of 10, it might be a gym workout or whatever outdoors, make sure you keep the social distancing. Even if you're out with friends sitting down in a park, make sure, and they're close friends, you've known them all your life, make sure you keep social distancing.
There was only one new case among more than 5,000 tests. Let's check in with Canberra next and political reporter Fiona Whelan. Fiona, the Prime Minister has faced questions about the future of the JobKeeper program.
Well, Mark, these are the payments keeping nearly 5 million Australians employed. Now, we were told from the start, like all of the economic measures announced, that the program would run for 6 months, ending in September. We were also told it would be reviewed at the halfway mark. And today, Scott Morrison has been asked what will be considered in that review. So is it possible the payments will be rolled back early as people get back to work and businesses reopen? Is it possible they'll be extended? This was his answer.
How that program can be adjusted to better support over that period, or if there are sectors that come under greater strain over a longer period of time. These are all things that the government is fully aware of. But we are not going to get ahead of ourselves here. We are 6 weeks into a six-month program.
Now, tomorrow, the Treasurer will give an update on the economy. Now, under normal circumstances, he would be handing down the federal budget because it's the second Tuesday of May. However, that has been pushed back to October due to a coronavirus. Late last year, the government had been forecasting a $5 billion surplus. Obviously, things have changed dramatically. And today, Deloitte Access Economics has released some figures forecasting a deficit of $143 billion this year and more than $131 billion next year.
They are huge deficits, not just because we're paying things like JobKeeper, but because we won't be paying tax. But those deficits are good news. It's money left in the pockets of families and businesses when they need it most.
Now, economists say the biggest problem will be unemployment. It's expected to remain high for another 4 years. I will learn how much it's increased so far when the official figures are released on Thursday. Mark.
Fiona, thank you for that. Well, now to Kate Creedon outside Emu Plains Public School in the city's west, where children are making their long-awaited return to the classroom.
Well, it's been a very successful transition back to school here at Emu Plains Public, where I can tell you the kids were practically skipping through the front gate this morning. We caught up with Mrs. Hammerson's Year 3 class, who they were all very excited to be back with their classmates after so long in isolation. Parents we spoke to were also very pleased to be dropping their kids off today and say they have a newfound respect for their teachers after taking on the role themselves at home. Now, this return to school will be staggered. These kids are only attending one day a week for now, while other years will attend on different days. But we're already hearing from the state government, if all goes well, they could be back full time within weeks.
The managed and phased return to school has been the right call by us as a government. And as the Premier outlined, if the next couple of weeks go well, I'm certainly keen as Education Minister to get all our children back into the classroom as quickly as possible. And we're hoping that that's the case by the end of May.
Now, the majority of kids are back at school here today. However, parents who have health concerns are still permitted to keep their children at home. However, they do need to keep up that learning from home and complete the same work as their classmates so they don't fall behind.
Former AFL coach Dean Laidley has been granted bail after being arrested on stalking charges earlier this month. He has been taken to a residential rehab facility, which the AFL Players Association has offered to pay for. It comes after two Victorian officers were suspended after images of Laidley in custody were leaked to the media. Well, veteran trade union leader and the founder of Sydney's Green Band movement, Jack Mundy, has died at the age of 90. The Communist Party member led the charge for the protection of heritage sites at the Rocks and Woolloomooloo in the early 1970s. Greens MPs have paid tribute to Mundy, calling him a champion for the planet.